A dramatic rescue of an 18-month-old baby named Lily, clinging to life after spending 14 hours hanging upside down in her car seat in a car crash that killed her mother. It's a harrowing rescue caught on this police officer body cam.
Got it, got it. Here, pass her up, pass her up. Here, right here, right here.
Go, 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 go.
911, what is the address of your emergency?
There's a car in the river.
Okay.
It's upside down.
And you see the person?
Yeah, I can see a hand.
Do they look like they're moving at all?
No, they don't.
Spanish Fork River, about 50 miles outside Salt Lake City. Police race to the scene, and there they find a 25-year-old mother, Lynn Grosbeck, and her baby. The woman dead, the baby girl unconscious, but breathing.
We're almost there. Are you getting a pulse? Couldn't feel any.
Officer Tyler Beddoes is one of the first to arrive on scene, but then something strange happens. Beddoes says he and three other officers hear a voice begging for help.
We heard a voice, a distinct voice. It wasn't thinking. It wasn't, we actually heard someone say, help me now, that type of stuff.
The crew jumps into action, rolling the car on its side.
Something was there, and that pushed us harder. When we heard that voice, to us, it was somebody's alive in that car. Let's get in there and get them out. So anything we could do to get inside that car, we tried to do.
It's there that rescuers see Lily, her head just inches above the water, where she dangled all night long. But who's the beckoning voice? Where did it come from? It remains a mystery.
We all together said, yes, we heard that same voice. And so when we really talked about it, it was then that it kicked in. The mom was obviously deceased when the car was flipped over, and the baby was unconscious at the time. And so for us, it was just, you know, processing, still processing what occurred and what happened.
Our Utah affiliate, KSTU, following the story. The ambulance racing Lily to the hospital. Her life hanging in the balance.
That little child looked lifeless. She was completely pale, lethargic. I mean, she was just no movement in that little child whatsoever, soaking wet.
Come on, sweetie. I couldn't get anything popped. Where's your scissors at? Come on, baby. Come on. Come on, sweetie.
A resident in the area recalls hearing a loud noise around 10:30 p.m. The fisherman didn't spot the partially submerged car until 12:30 the next afternoon.
She had visited some family in Salem last night around 10 o'clock. She left Salem between 10 and 10:30 last night, was headed home to Springville. The family didn't know that she did not arrive.
Miraculously, Lily survives. Her father captured here on cell phone video with his precious baby girl.
She's doing all of her nursery rhymes. She's no more monkeys on the bed, the wheels on the bus. She knows everything she knew before anything happened. It's amazing.
But how did the car wind up upside down in the river? The answers come the next day. When investigators sweep the car, there they find an array of drugs.
There was a small baggie of marijuana located in the vehicle, and then there was also a syringe.
Detectives also find tramadol, a strong prescription pain med. Its side effects, seizures and drowsiness. And while investigators process their findings, the police department and fire and rescue are honored for their quick actions that saved Lily's life.
It's memories that we'll never forget, but we talk about it as a crew still. We discuss things and we shed tears, hugs.
Well, it's hard to describe that feeling because it was, I mean, to see her, I remember grabbing her hand and she's looking up into my eyes, you know, like nothing happened, but there was almost that connection there.
The toxicology report on Lily's mom comes back. The findings are disturbing, revealing a pharmacy's worth of drugs in the woman's system, including morphine, codeine, and a substance that indicates heroin use. Tragically, the mom's life was cut short, and doctors hope that little Lily won't remember the traumatic night when she was hanging by a thread.